I'm up. Or would they wanna see me drown and drown as I pour another cup? I remember taking bus. Want my face up on a bus. Took a perk, got me stuck. Hey, what's cracking? Stone Age Jamar here. Welcome. Welcome, everyone. To my Red Dead Redemption series online on my YouTube channel. You can catch me at Twitch at twitch.tv/TonyChamara. I go live every other day. Bunch of variety of content. This in particular video here is going to be showcasing a lot of my top cheeses that I like to use on a daily basis. They're unpatched or still working. I call them cheeses. You can call them exploits. Some people call them glitches. Either way, they're in the game to help us out, because at the end of the day, Rockstar is trying to extort us, so we need to survive out here. Okay, so I'm here to help you, help me, help you. So sit back, relax, grab some popcorn, and let's jump into it. It's the first one here. This is the Blood Money mission. Stagecoach, stick up. Basically, it's unlimited treasure maps. Now, I'm going to let you all know, as a disclaimer, from the jump, I don't really use this that much, but I want to put it on there because it's there, okay? It works for Anthony Foreman and Sean McGuire. This in particular footage, and when I found the map, I found it at Anthony Foreman at Rhodes. So as long as you get Stagecoach stick up, you could essentially do it. But these two in particular, they're just very easy, especially Foreman out in Rhodes. It's very simple, shoot from the ranch and you go all the way up to Heartlands. Yeah, so we're gonna jump into that. And I'll show you basically what you do. It still works. It's not the greatest. I got Bard's Crossing, which is coming up next. It's much more effective in my opinion. So, and my apologies for how long this video is, but I was trying to make sure that I didn't put no cuts in. As less cuts as possible. So there you go. Stagecoach, stick up. And then basically, you see down here, we got the Jeb Phelps contract. We're going to do a video on that later. And then you got the I believe it's the railroad contract, and that one, both these two missions is like basically unlimited capital. It's out there, it's been out there for a while. This is old school, this is nothing new. However, I'm going to cover it in a different way to make it a little bit more easier, because I found some videos that I found weren't as detailed and, you know, user friendly, so to speak. So we're gonna cut the cutscenes. We're gonna skip that. We don't need that. Basically, you're gonna go up from here. We're gonna start here. There's a waypoint that's bringing us to a little house on the ranch. You don't want to go near that, okay? Because you don't want to activate the actual mission. What you want to do is you want to go around it. I believe like east around the house, or you could go around the left side, which I guess northwest, and try and go right up the road through Rhodes all the way up to Heartlands. You got one here, one there. You got two up top. We got one there and one here, and then you got one down here, I believe. Yeah. So they're a mixture of maps on a tree and treasure hunters. So this in particular one is going to be on a tree with a bunch of skulls. Looks like a voodoo lady lives there. I got this on the first run. And like I said, I don't use this all the time, but I have used it. I was using it before Bard's Crossing, so it's not like completely obsolete. However, once you start doing the Bard's Crossing, you'll understand why I'm saying like I don't really use this one. This is just here. I just wanted to show you guys that it still works. It's legit. And yeah, all of this stuff as well, it's done in MTU lobbies. So if you guys don't know how to put yourself in an MTU lobby, there's tons of videos on YouTube that you can look up and find. I will probably be doing one later on just to show how to do it. But you want to be in an MTU lobby. I'm using an 800 MTU to basically, you could use between 600 and 910 or something like that I use. All right, so soon here, there we go. We're going to have the tree popping up here. And then as soon as you pull the map, and you see it on your screen, you're going to hotkey disconnect. And if you don't know how to do that, there's many videos out there on YouTube to do it. And I will also be, putting a video out there showing how to do it on the PS5. Next one here, one of my favorite, like I said, this is the Bard's Crossing. Unlimited gold, cash, valuables, treasure maps, all that good stuff. You're going to start in Blackwater. You're basically going to be next to the butcher. There's a stall right there. You could be on your horse, you could be standing. I did it looking south, so I don't know if that means anything. You could look north, look south, but you basically want to be standing right here to spawn your camp
right over here. Okay, so I believe it's going to be Bard's Crossing. It's the map. You're gonna want to pull the camp. Sorry, Bard's Crossing, to get it right there. All right, it should spawn right away. It did it for me many times. But all these markers you see around, this is where the gold is going to be spawning around the camp. But there's only one in particular one, maybe two, one that's right above the camp and one right here. You want them on either two of those locations. And then the map on the tree is right across from that one right there. So as you can see, we have we spawned a map somewhere far away from our camp. And now basically we're going to scroll down and... we're going to be, well, as you can see, I got all the maps. That's what I was showing you. I got all 29 maps. So you're going to want to open Bard's Crossing map. And it should spawn. If it does spawn in the place that we want it, it should spawn right over here. So we're going to go towards here. And as soon as you come close, your controller should start vibrating. As soon as you come... like me, I like to come right around the rock just to make sure. But the controller is vibrating. So that means jackpot. And yeah, so you're just going to make your way over here. Now the first time you do this, you do not want to pick up the gold. Okay? As soon as you come here for the first time, you're going to fast travel from Blackwater to the camp when you spawned it here. When you get to the camp, you're going to go into the online menu. You're going to pull open the online, go to camp, and you're going to respawn at the camp. Then you're going to come here, and then you're going to, before you open the gold, you're going to do the same thing. You're going to spawn to your camp. Once you do that, then you could come and start opening them. And then when you finish opening them, you're going to proceed to go over here. And you got the train music, the train sounds in the background and stuff. That shit could get a little bit annoying after a while, but you got this map here that's on a tree every single time. I can't stress enough that this map is here every time. That's why when you go and pick up the Bard's map, it's better to when you have all the maps, because if you use the map and open the chest, you basically come here and it's going to give you the Bard's right back. So as you can see, as soon as I took that map and put it in my pocket and seen the name on the screen, I hotkey disconnect. So this is where it's going to be a little bit long, because I wanted to show like straight loading screen. This is a PS5, so it's a little bit faster than the PS4, but I didn't want to do no cuts, like nothing. I just want to show you straight from disconnecting, going into the menu, respawning at the camp, all of that, all in one cut. My apologies. I really, really do apologize. I did not want to do a 35-minute long video, but this is, you know, c'est la vie. So we're loading. We're gonna load back here in here in a second. All right. So we loaded back in. As you can see, it's all gold around the map, the mini map. That means we still have the map. It's still spawned. It's still right there. Even though we just opened it and we went and got the map off the tree. So it's still there. So I'm going to do another run just so you can see where, you know, this is the same cut, same clip, no cuts, all raw. I'm going to grab our horse here. Where's the horse? Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Let's go, Jesus. It's not Jesus. It's Jesus, okay? Don't judge me. I love this horse. I'm going to upgrade this horse suit because I've had it forever. So, all right. So we came back here. And, you know, controller is vibrating again. So we're going to go right down. So now that, once again, you came here for the first time, you don't have to worry about doing the whole double camp respawns when you get here. That's just to activate the cheese. So when you get here, boom, you got the treasure chest. We're gonna open this sucker up because we want the gold. And every time you open this, it's not gonna be the same. Sometimes you might get a little bit of gold, a little bit of money. Sometimes you might get a lot. You know what I mean? This one in particular, we got, you know, 0.81 gold, $120. We got some snake oil, that's perfect. You know what I mean? The last one, I believe we got like 1.21 or something like that. I don't. I think the most I seen was like one in almost over 1.5 grams of gold, or 1.5 bars of gold. All right, this goddamn train, I don't understand. I feel like it always is here every time we're here. Otherwise, it's not. So we're gonna go right, straight, right across to this tree. And once again, the map is going to be right there, as you can see. It is right there. So every time you use the Bard's Crossing treasure map, you grab the treasure chest, the gold, and whatever. You come here, you grab your map, and you hotkey disconnect. You spawn right back into your camp, rinse and repeat. That's pretty much, this is, my opinion, the best way to get all your maps and a good solid way to get gold. Not as good as the Lake Isabella, which we're going to jump into shortly, but this is a very, very, very good cheese that still works. All right, so this is one of my favorite. Okay, before you do Lake Isabella, you got to come down to a fence. We're at a fence here in Thieves Landing, and the reason why we're coming here is because we need to get some dynamite. Basically, if you could loot people, you could get dynamite in many places. But at the fence right here, you want to come here, you want to grab some dynamite. It's the easiest way to do it, and it doesn't take that long. Just come here, stroll up to this young fella. How's it going, buddy? What are you smoking on? And yeah, we're going to go down here, we're going to grab some dynamite. It's $1 each, very cheap. I always just grab a bunch and make sure we're, you know, 7-8 full stock. That's what we want, because you need the dynamite to place on the chest to blow it up to activate this cheese. So we're here. All right, this is where you want to be. This is the spot. When you have the Lake Isabella map, you want to come up here, make yourself a little waypoint here, and it's essentially going to be right at the corner of a rock or a hill and a rock. And where if you'll know the gold is there, there's going to be, we're looking for a canoe. It's going to have like a broken, like half of a canoe broken, kind of submerged in the ice right next to the treasure chest. That's what we're looking for. So as you can see, it's not here. This one, sometimes it doesn't spawn all the time here, but it's like every one or two, maybe three times that you keep on respawning your treasure map. You go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. This one is as well in an MTU lobby, and you need a friend. I'm using a second account. I have my wife's account, but you know, if you have a second account or you have a friend that could sit in here and do it, but you definitely need another person for this to work. So I'm going to call my horse here, and we're basically going to go to a spot. Okay, you're going to go right directly east from the actual chest. Okay, the chest is west. You're going to go east right into these trees. It's right down, like literally a beeline from the chest to this tree. I found this spot worked, so I'm going to basically open another map. We're going to open the East Watson map because it's right above Lake Isabella in the list. We'll spawn the East Watson map. You can spawn any map, it doesn't matter, just some map that's different than the Lake Isabella map. And then once you have that spawned, you're going to go and we're going to open up Lake Isabella. And once we do that, then we'll be able to respawn the chest somewhere around us, and hopefully it goes to the place where we want it to go. Very simple, very easy, easy peasy. All right, we got it open. Let's check it out. I love this light on my horse. It's so lit. Lit. All right, so we're going to go down here. We're going to check it out. Is it going to start vibrating? I think it's going to start vibrating. Whoa, oh, Jesus. Come on. That's a cold bath for you, horse. So I could already see it over there. I see the broken canoe. I don't know what the hell I'm doing right now, but we're gonna pop some potions. Here we go. Alright. So we got the treasure chest to spawn where we want. Controller is vibrating off the, like, it's gonna fall out of my hand right now. So it's right here. You're gonna bring in your other friend. This one here is my wifey. She used to be Beauty XO HMR, but now she's Demon XO Girl. So you're going to put your other character, your friend or your second account is going to go right where she is. So right before the little white patch on the rock. That's the little sweet spot. Okay. So once again, this is an MTU lobby. I got a friend. We're not in a posse, none of that. Just come in, make sure this person joins you. If you're in an MTU lobby, make sure the other person has the same settings as you, otherwise it won't work. And most of the time, I found joining MTU lobbies only work if you're on the same internet. It's weird, I don't know what it is. So, everything's all set up, we're ready to go. We're gonna get our dynamite out here, okay? Because we gotta get our dynamite on this chest. So you're gonna come up here. To place it, you wanna hold R2 down, okay? I learned the hard way, threw it, blew myself up. It was really, really embarrassing. I don't know what happened. I need Jesus in my life. So you're gonna put the dynamite stick on the chest and you're gonna walk away, kind of a little bit, like, just not too far. You don't have to be that far. Just so you don't blow yourself up, and your friend is gonna be as close as possible, but not too close, so they don't get blown up either. So now that we've done that, this is where basically the cheese, it starts, okay? Now, the way this works is, you have this rock here, okay? This rock, as soon as you get to this rock, your little gold emblem, the little treasure map thing, the X, it's gonna disappear as soon as you get to this rock. And all you're gonna do is just run around in a circle. Run around, run around, run around, run around. I'm speeding this up a little bit. So the more times, basically the first couple of times I only did it for a few minutes just to see my yield, see how much I would get. I think I posted three runs in this video, all in the same period of time, but some I got more gold than others. I believe the most was, I think it was like 55 gold, and I was running for about 15 minutes around that rock. Works the best if you go in first person. But so before you open this chest though, before you open this chest, make sure you open another map. Don't have the Lake Isabella map open, because if you open that chest with the Lake Isabella map still activated, you're gonna lose that map and you're gonna have to go back and do either the Stagecoach or a Barge Crossing, or you're gonna have to go and Lake Isabella is one of the hardest maps to get. So unless you have all the maps, you're not gonna get it back that fast. So remember, open new map before you open the chest. All right, so we started here. I believe we're at like 32 gold or something. This was 2, 3, 4 times or something already. I believe that's 4. I think that's 5. Gonna keep going again. Tons of stuff. This is beautiful. I mean, this is a beautiful way to stack up. Look at that. We just got in this run, that was plus 12 gold. We're at 44 now. Tons of money, tons of chewing tobacco, health tonics, all kinds of stuff. This right here, if you have the time to grind all day, you could make a ton of gold, a ton of cash, and everything else that you need. So that was the first run. We're gonna go to this another run where I was running for probably twice as long as I did last time. Okay, I just wanted to see exactly the sweet spot in how long I needed to really run and how much I would get back. So once again, before I open the chest, you want to go to your treasure maps. You want to open up another treasure map. It doesn't really matter what it is. Just open it up. You open up the treasure map, and then boom, you open up the treasure chest, and you're good to go. And it still lets you open it up. You're good to go. So let's see this one. What are we going to get here? All right, got 1.4 gold, $46. Got a special miracle tonic pamphlet. We got a miracle tonic. 0.92 gold, $100. Got some health cure tonics. You got 1.1 gold. Got $93. Some cigarettes. 1.28 gold, $100. You know, it's just tons of valuables. Another bar of gold. Another $100. You know, another bar of gold. $85. So it's inconsistent. 1.1 gold, $115, and that's it. So we just went up 10 gold there. So I think maybe I had these clips backwards. I think this was the shorter time and the other one was longer. But either way, this was under like 8 minutes or so. 6 to 8 minutes I ran around that rock. This next one is when I actually ran for about 15 minutes, and I think that's the sweet spot. 15 to 20 minutes. This one, though, is pretty long, but I want you guys to see it from start to finish, okay? This basically was a lot of me pulling, all right? It was a lot. I was watching a podcast, put on my iTunes, just listen to First Take, you know, or Skip Bailey there, whatever, the Undisputed. Just listen to some sports podcasts and just sat here and pressed X for like 5 minutes. It was amazing. But I went up like almost 60 gold. You guys want to go check out how much Rockstar is charging you for 60 gold? 20 minutes of your time? Yeah. So first one here, we're going to open it up. As you can see, we started at 78 gold. That went really quick. We started at 78 gold. So I just wanted to show you guys that. It's 120 bucks. Got another 1.1 bars. 48 bucks, not bad. 1.27 bars. Another 107 bucks. 1.29 gold. 93 bucks. We're just getting, look, healthcare potions off the chain, bro. Like, look at this. This is ridiculous. This is amazing. You know, for a while, I was grinding the hell out of those bounties and everything. And it's just like, this was a life, this is a game changer. Lifesaver. So, look at that. We're at 91 gold already. Okay, 91. Just got, look, there's half a bar right there. It's not bad. Man, we got 1.1 bars. It's beautiful. This is just unlimited gold, basically. You don't even have to worry about gold, money, valuables. You're gonna get tons of stuff here. Tons of chewing gum, tons of miracle potions, tons of health cure potions. Beautiful. All right, so we got, you know, 3/4 of a bar right there, 75 bucks. We got some snake oil, got 1.6 bars right there. And we're still going. Like, this is, we're still going. We're at 102 bars. This is beautiful. This is absolutely beautiful. So I'm going to let you guys watch this. I'm going to speed it up a little bit right now, and then we'll come back and we'll figure it out. And there we go, 132 gold. That's like 54, 55 gold we just got in 20 minutes. 15, 20 minutes of running around a rock. It's ridiculous. The amount of money that they charge you, that Rockstar charges you for that amount of gold, it's just, this is just amazing. This is the best way to grind your gold and your money and valuables up. So next, this is one closest to my heart. I love being a trader. I love hunting. I love shooting shit. This is awesome. This is a good way to level up your trader. This is a good strategy for your camp to be in, so you can hunt and just keep feeding materials to Crips so he can break it down and make goods for you to go out and deliver. It's really dope. So at first, we're going to run it just straight up.
All right, time for a little lesson on supply and demand. Now, when Group 1, us, has a demand for supplies, and Group 2, them, has said supplies in their possession, how do we rebalance the economy? By robbing them blind, of course. Simple.
Now, the reason why I'm running it straight up and not jumping right into the cheese is I want to show what happens after when you do it normally, and also, it doesn't hurt to run the resupply missions instead of buying supplies. I know people will just go and buy them. If you're trying to level up your trader, you want to just run these resupply missions because they give you lots of XP. 500 trader XP and 500 personal XP, which is pretty dope. They give you some cash, but we're not really worried about the cash. We're just trying to get XP fast. So the resupply missions give you a lot of XP off the rip. However, after you do a few back to back, the XP starts going down. So it's essentially becomes like you don't really need to do it like 10 times. You're going to want to do the delivery missions, but the resupply missions, you don't want to do it over and over and over again for hours, because it's not, you get more doing the delivery, but it's the same method. So this is the resupply one. We just, boom, we just went, jacked the caravan, jacked the wagon. We're going to bring it back to Crips, and you'll see the difference between us finishing it right now and then having to activate a new resupply, which you can't because Crips is already supplied. Basically, you don't have to worry about giving him anymore. All right, as you can see right down here, 500 trader XP, beautiful. All right, now this is where we're gonna do the cheese part of it. See this tree right in front of us? Remember this tree. So this is the location where you're going to want to be standing. You could be on your horse or you could be standing, but you need to be facing north of the map. Okay, you got to be right at this location, and you're going to pull out your small camp and your wheel. You're going to pull open your camps, and you're going to pick Gaptooth Ridge. If you're in this spot, it should spawn right there at the bottom. And it's, the reason why is the delivery spots are Scratching Post and Benedict Point. These two spots are like literally really close to your camp. So this, for this cheese, you're going to either, hopefully you want, we want Scratching Point, but sometimes you'll get Benedict Point. But if you get Scratching Point, it's right in front of your camp. So this is perfect. All right. So you're basically going to go, you're going to hit start resupply. As soon as you go into the screen, you're going to join a friend. Okay. You're going to join a friend, any person, someone has to be in Red Dead Redemption. Second account's the best. But you're going to join a friend. As soon as you join a friend, you're going to see this. This is no cuts, same clip. I wanted to keep it funky. I wanted to keep it 100 so you guys knew that there's no bullshit going on here. This is all one clip. You're going to go in, join a friend. Soon as you start the mission and Crip starts talking. And if you do it correctly, you're going to see this alert. It's no problem. Press X. And it's going to load us back in, but it's weird because we're not going to have anything on the map. If you look at our mini map, if we pull open, you shouldn't have anything on the map. There's no activities, no nothing. So we're going to go to this one little spot right at this road, right above Scratching Point. That's where we want to come back. As soon as you load in, you're going to want to get on your horse, and you're going to want to get back to that spot, because that's where we're going to activate the cheese. The cheese has already been activated, but we're going to initiate it, I guess you want to say. So we're going to grab our horse over here. What's going on, Jesus? Take a shot. All right. So this part here, I did a couple cuts. It's definitely not interesting watching this horse gallop. All right, so once you pass this these trade tracks, you got this road right here. As soon as you pass this road, that's where you're going to initiate the glitch. You're going to see all your look at the minimap. All of the little orange things are all disappearing. As soon as that happens, you're going to go turn around, go right past this this road, and it will activate the resupply mission. You see? Boom. So now we're going to go and do the resupply mission. We're going to go to Gaptooth Breach. We're going to grab this wagon real quick. And then right after it, I'm going to show you exactly what this cheese does. So we're going to take these guys out real quick. Headshots. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, we're going to grab this wagon. All right, this chemical wagon. We need chemicals to break down meat. I don't know. I don't know what they'd be doing back then in the 1960s or something like that, but it's kind of suspect. I don't know. But anyways, chemical wagons. So we're going to grab this wagon. We're going to bring it back. I'm going to do a nice little cut. And once we get back to Crips, I'll show you guys exactly what to do. All right, so we're here. It's beautiful. So you're not going to see the place where to bring it, but you want to come close to your camp. It's going to immediately go into like a little black screen, and you delivered it. Beautiful. Crips is happy. Get to work. I don't know why I pay you. You're just sitting there doing nothing. All right, so once again, no cuts, no nothing, same clip, boom, mission passed. Got 15 units there. I don't understand why. You get shot one time, boom, they take away 5 of your materials. It's dumb. But anyways, with this cheese, you could do, you know, unlimited resupply missions. So as you can see, our map, we have no activities on the map, nothing at all. It's just locations where to go, but there's no stranger missions, there's no blood money missions, there's no nothing. That's how you know that this is activated and working. So you're gonna get back on your horse. You could run there if you want, or you get on your horse, and we're gonna go back to that road. Because once we pass that road, and sometimes they'll spawn people here too. It's really nice XP. You'll see people will spawn here, but this is also where a delivery mission is. So it's beautiful. So this road right up here, as soon as we pass it, we're gonna get a black screen. Beautiful. Activated. And that's what we want. And boom. Resupply. Another mission. So now we're going all the way to Tumbleweed. This one's a little bit further. This cheese for the resupply missions, it's not like the best. There's another few spots that are much better, but I like this for like overall for deliveries, for getting animals, and for the resupply. If you get the ones close by, you're good to go. It's a good 1-2-3 stop type of thing, you know what I'm saying? So enjoy. I hope you guys all like it. It's unpatched, it's still working as of Christmas 2022. Get it. And that's a wrap, folks. That's basically, in a summary, some of my favorite cheeses that I use daily in Red Dead Redemption. There's tons of them, okay? There's tons of YouTube videos with lots of different tricks. I don't really like tricks that are like taking Ethernet out and stuff like that. So these are just everyday cheeses that anybody could do. It helps out. Rockstar extorts the hell out of us. And this is survival mode right now, okay? So I'm here to help. And I got a bunch of different variety of content coming in Red Dead. We're going to do some more in-depth leveling up for the Naturalist. I know the Moonshiner, I haven't even started. So my Bounty Hunter's maxed, and my Collector's is maxed. I'm trying to get Traders up, Naturalist up, and Moonshiner. So those are going to be my Red Dead Redemption Online series in the future. I hope everyone enjoyed and liked the content. I hope it's helpful for you. You could like, share, subscribe. Go catch me at twitch.tv/ToneHMR. Hit me up with a follow, with a subscribe there. I go every other day live there. There's tons of different variety of content. But once again, thank you. Appreciate it. It's ToneHMR. I'm out. I wouldn't want to be your friend if you let me. I don't want friends. I want a Bentley. Drive around town going top speed. Let the top down, bump in high heat. Do not fall in love when I fuck you. Cause in a year's time, it'll be fuck me. I'm responsible for everyone around me. For those who hated on me, you can blow me. Do you love me now? Would they love me when I'm up? Or would they wanna see me drown? As I pour another cup. I remember taking bus. Wore my face up on a bus. Took a perk, got me stuck. Cause somebody help me.